I would say it's a revolution because this is the first one that you can drive on that feels like a regular car. It's obviously an evolution because it's taken time to get there, and we've evolved through a couple of iterations of Run Flats to get from where we were to where we are. But in terms of the response and what you can expect, it is a revolution.
I drove the new one first and I thought, this car rides pretty well. Then I got into the other car and I thought, well, it feels like the tyre pressures are too high. Basically, the ride was busier. You know, it was always jiggling. You could always feel the car moving. And the new one seems to have solved a lot of that problem.
I'd say that the tyre has a lot less vibration and a lot less noise than the previous tyres that I've been on. I can see that development's coming a long way. So I think once it becomes apparent to the marketplace that a Run Flat can be like a high performance tyre, I think they'll take off.
We actually run them with no air pressure in them at normal earlier today. And I was impressed again with no air pressure in it. It really does its job, gets you from A to B. I tried the old generation first and I didn't actually find it to be too bad. The suspension travel was quite busy and it was quite crashy over some of the harsher stuff. Then jumping into the new generation was quite a big difference, and I was fairly impressed with it actually.
I think if you're a sympathetic driver and if you understand the car and you can do the back-to-back comparison, you'll see or you'll feel, you know, quite a significant difference in terms of, particularly you'll notice that the difference in noise, I believe. I believe turn-in is roughly the same, but ride comfort is obviously quite significantly better. I believe that sort of grip and most other qualities are in the same general ballpark, but I think that there are incremental differences that are definitely work to the advantage of the new tyre.
From my perspective, it's certainly much quieter. There doesn't seem to be the harshness that crept in occasionally, especially on coarse road chip surfaces, where you can hear the tyre and also feel it far more than with the latest version, which is a much more compliant tyre. So I think it's an interesting example of how added technology continues to improve that particular type of product.